Chairwoman Kirkpatrick.
Welcome to the subcommittee of the Health and Human Services Committee. We have one bill on our agenda today, House Bill 520. We're going to have the bill presented, starting with Representative Jones, Sherman Jones, and Representative Oliver. Okay, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Madam Chairwoman. What would be the, I'll say, first indicators or second indicators of mental health or substance abuse? Madam Chairwoman, that is the end of my comments.
Thank you, and I know you're going to have to leave, but we're going to go ahead, Representative Oliver, if you could cover the other sections, and then if you're willing to take all the questions, that'd be great.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'm very happy to be here, and I appreciate the privilege of presenting another opportunity for the state to move forward on mental health reform.
We're going to limit individuals to 2 minutes.
First of all, thank you for the opportunity. Second of all, came all the way down here from Cumming for 120 seconds of airtime, which I think is really unfair. I'd like for everyone who is against this bill to please stand up. The most egregious part of this bill that I find is the fact that the lead sponsor for the bill owns a company who stands to benefit from its passing. That is because he owns a monitoring company that does monitoring that is described in the bill. He had the same monitoring described in 1013 last year, and thankfully, for the hard work of the Senate, that monitoring aspect was removed. But he stands to gain from this. He and his partners stand to gain from this bill passing, and he's putting funding and he's putting grants in order to fund these different aspects of health.
Madam Chair, I wonder if that would be appropriate for his testimony to be when Chairman Jones is here. Sounds a little bit unfair that he's out
there. Chairman Jones had the opportunity to be here.
Do you have choice?
Do you have line numbers in the bill that you're referring to?
Did he should have stayed.
Start his time again.
Yes.
You can
look at line numbers 551 through 558, 545 through 550. You're going to find that these line numbers deal with professional health care program, defining the professional health care program, and the fact that monitoring and rehabilitation of impaired health care professionals for the purpose of this, that, and the other thing. Impaired means the inability of a healthcare professional to practice and reasonable skill and safety to patients by reason of illness or use of alcohol, drugs, narcotics, and chemicals. What he's done is he's defined what his product does, which is a monitoring device. It monitors biometrics as well as GPS. So he's defined in the bill what his particular device actually does that's patented. And he's marketed this to Tennessee. He's marketed, it's in three states right now. It's now in Paulding County and in Fulton County. And I'd like for my entire remarks to go to the committee if I could.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Senators, for ridding Georgia of TikTok and Chinese tracking.
Yes.
Mental Health Equity 1.0 HB 1013 was gutted by senators a year ago. Senators prudently removed numerous references to the World Health Organization's definition for mental health and stopped the possibility of TikTok-like Chinese biometric wristbands and components from being used in Georgia mental health care. Now Mental Health Equity 2.0 HB 520 unexplainably allows for TikTok-like tracking, but 10 times worse. Mental Health Parity 2.0 fails to provide any meaningful definitions, as you've heard here. What is mental health? What is mental illness? What is serious mental illness? What is monitoring? HB 520 cites these things numerous times. Who monitors? How do you monitor? Are these going to use Chinese components, pieces, and parts for monitoring? Who maintains the data? What if the company that's there sells their company? Then what happens to the data? Presumably, these questions will be left up to a few elite mental health czars. And if I'm wrong, then what would be the harm in banning any and all aspects related to China as it results to any and all monitoring of any kind relative to Mental Health Equity 2.0? There would be no harm, so why not do that? But the most important information is during last year's Senate hearings for HB 1013 was that Mental Health Equity was overturned on March 22, 2022 by the Federal Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals, Witt versus United Behavioral Health. Had that been known by this body a year ago, Georgia Mental Health Equity would not have just been gutted, but it would have been halted. The very name of last year's bill, HB 1013, Mental Health Equity, was based on the notion that a federal mandate existed for mental health equity. There are ample arguments during last year's hearing based on a federal mandate which no longer exists. That was deliberately withheld from this body. I have supplied, and I believe somebody's going to pass out the open records that I obtained, to where the proponents and one of the bill sponsors deliberately withheld that information during the Senate hearings last year. That is wrong. That should not have stopped. That should have stopped. Please oppose HB 10, HB 520. Table it. Don't let this legislation go any further. Thank you.
Thanks to everyone for coming down. Stay tuned. This is a long process. We're just the beginning of it. Thanks very much, George Jones.